magic or any supernatural elements around you. Now, this topic has not come from any one of you. No mails have been written to us also regarding this. It's only that very recently somebody contacted us, a girl from India itself, and she came up with this issue of the black magic detection. So I spoke to her, and of course I will not name her. She is from India itself, and my team member Ajay told me that this is a very urgent case, and she had sent a photograph of her dog Beagle. It was a breed Beagle, and very young age of the dog. So this made me go through this case very urgently, and I saw the photographs of the dog and everything. But before I proceed on, I said that before also I made a video on how Ketu and dogs are related very closely, and this was an awareness video before also, and many of you have benefited out of it, because astrology ki had explained that do not believe astrologers who say that, you know, just go ahead and feed a dog for a purpose. No, there has to be no purpose. It's just that it's a living being, and you have to help the creatures which are actually under you. That is your responsibility as humans, okay? Our responsibility as humans. So anyways, you can go ahead and watch that video and have more details about it. Today's topic is very, very specific, that this lady came to me, and I do not speak with people on the phone without telephonic conversations and consultations which are already booked. Now, those are also very rarely booked, because we do all the correspondence through the mail itself. But whenever there's an animal query, mostly when it's about dogs, cats, or, you know, creatures who are voiceless, I always make sure that wherever I am, and if it's possible, if the network is available, I do speak directly as to what is causing a problem for a living creature who's voiceless. So carrying forward the same promise that I made to myself, that I would always be there for the voiceless creatures, I immediately came on the call and I spoke with the girl. And I thought that she's very worried about the dog, and that's exactly what she told my assistant Ajay, that she's really, really worried for the dog, because every night, and after the night also, it became a routine of morning, day, evening, and the night, that the dog was looking at one particular cupboard in her room and barking. And this was happening from November 2020, I'm talking about. She mentioned this was happening from November 2020, and now this has increased so much. And from November, and she contacted us in the month of February. So now the dog is unable to walk also. The situation has arisen like this, and the dog keeps on barking, and the dog is always disturbed. So she said she's very worried about the dog. So I said, okay, fine, get the diagnosis done for the dog and let me see what the problem with the dog is. So then when I asked her that, has she consulted any doctor for it? She said, yes, I have consulted a doctor, and the doctor gave some medicines. And I said, so what came out in the diagnosis? What came out in the reports of the dog medically when you go to a vet? So then she says, no, there was no diagnosis done. There was no test done for the dog. Some doctor just simply said that it's quite possible that he has distemper. Now, people who have kept dogs or who are aware of the animal diseases, distemper is one of the common things that happen in the dogs, if not taken care of. So she said it is distemper. So this was a guess game which was happening between the doctor and her. She says he gave some medicines to the dog and nothing happened, and I've spent 2,000-3,000 rupees already on the dog. So I said, I don't understand that. Why are you not consulting a good doctor for it? You know, and she says that out here in this place, she was from Amritsar in fact, there are no good doctors. And I fail to believe there are any good doctors in Amritsar, because I have a lot of people who are there who have dogs, and they keep their dogs very well. I said, okay, fine. Even if there is no, I agree to the fact, even I give you a benefit of doubt, if there is no good doctor in Amritsar, why don't you take the dog to Chandigarh for that matter? A nearby city. If you really love the dog, if you think the dog is your family member, of course you will go from one place to the other for the treatment. So then the reality came and the truth came out from her, that she was not interested very much in getting the dog cured. She was more interested in, you know, that Didi, you had said in that Ketu video of yours. Now this is the reason I mentioned that Ketu video in this video. You had mentioned in the Ketu video that dogs and cats and animals can see spirits, can see supernatural things around. And I was shocked. I was like, yes, of course I said that. But then you're more worried now about the fact that you're using your dog with the symptom of he or she looking at one particular thing and barking, and you referring to my video that because I had said this, they are able to see, you are capturing that and you're least bothered about the dog's survival, the medical survival. And when I said that I would recommend you to go ahead and first get the dog treated, she had number of excuses with her. From her own voice, I could make out that she's like, I have already spent, I come from a lower middle class family. I'm not trying to make fun of any lower middle class family people out here or a person out here. It is just that my point is, I always say this, if you do not have the capacity to keep a dog, why do you even keep or buy or adopt a dog? It's like having your own children, your own family member. Why are you having any dog if you do not have the capacity to spend on the dog or take the efforts or the pain to do something for the dog if the dog is medically ill? So that means you become so selfish that you have a dog and you're like, fine, you know, I said the dog will die. The dog will die, I told her. And she was just stammering on the call. She was like, yes, Didi. I said, what? If you don't have money, you're telling me you have no money, you should not keep the dog. Secondly, okay, fine, even if you've done that, have you asked for any help on Facebook, social media, your friends and everybody? What are your efforts? And she goes blank. She says, no, I have tried my best. She did not have any answers. I mean, one time I just wanted to say that take the money from me and get the dog treated, but I did not see any willingness from that girl's side at all. She was more bothered about the fact that, oh my god, I'm stuck because this call I made was for a diagnosis for myself and saying that I don't have money. But here the tables have turned now all of a sudden, because this spiritual healer who's sitting in front of me, who's talking to me on the phone, is more bothered about the dog's health rather than me saying that, you know, do something for me as per the diagnosis. I will not even move my finger from here to here for such people who use animals, who use my videos and blame my videos or come through my videos link with this kind of an act. And I told her very categorically that I will not do any diagnosis. First, I want the dog to be treated because I know the dog will die. And if even after such harsh statements and straightforward statements, this woman did not turn back to me and said, okay, fine, I would want to get this dog of mine cured and I would go ahead with the help. And I was waiting for that sentence from her. Okay, then I would have said that, okay, what contribution you're looking for? Let's collect money for the dog and go ahead. If I wanted, I could have given the money at once. But why should I give the money, my hard-earned money, to somebody who does not have the value of a living being, of a voiceless animal? I have a doubt on that person that even if I give money, she will not have the efforts to move her butt from her bed or her chair and go ahead outside the house and get that dog treated. Because from November to February, this woman is bullshitting with the dog and is not doing anything except having the symptoms that, okay, this dog is looking. So these people should not be in my channel. And if you're watching this, whoever the girl is, she knows I'm not naming the girl. Okay, and I'm the kind of person who can just go ahead with showing the photo of the person from collecting from Facebook. Me and my team is excellent in that. But I'm not doing that because you're not even worth it that I spend so much of time searching your photograph from Facebook or from your phone number. Because I know the dog is going to die. Okay, and such people would never get any benefit. These people, even if there is black magic, you know, I would want them to die in black magic. Because they don't have the value of a living creature, of a voiceless soul. So they don't deserve to be around me. They don't deserve to come into my channel. Unsubscribe my channel right away, such people. And get lost from my channel. Who do not have this much sensitivity towards a living soul, and they are using my video and connecting that video with the dogs and saying that you said, Didi, that dogs and cats can see. Yes, I said, but I did not tell this, that let them die, take the symptoms, see the symptom, let them die. I have gone personally myself ahead and done cures for people who have dogs and cats who do not afford money. They cannot afford the money. I've given them, I have done things for them. I will not do such things for humans because humans are greedy people, greedy souls, and they are not worth it. Worth me doing this. But for the voiceless creature who has come, I can go ahead and do things. And I've been always doing this. But humans, if you come to me for free services, the doors are closed like this completely. Because you don't value healers who are doing genuine work. You value doctors and engineers, but you will not value a honest healer. You think why a healer is earning money, why a healer is taking money. So you can just get lost from my channel right away. Especially people who are using their dogs and animals. Yes, but if you genuinely feel for that soul of that family member who is actually your family member, if you consider them to be, okay, then of course you can contact me, even if you're from a lower middle class family. So don't give this shit to me and this bullshit to me that I am from a lower middle class family. So that's why I could not treat the dog. Bloody hell, why did you even buy a dog or adopted a dog? So this video is not for any recommendations that do this, do that, except one thing. Have a heart, have a soul. At least be a human being. Act like one. And if you're not an animal lover also, it's okay. But at least you should be kind to the fact that there is a living soul out there. And what do you think? Okay, people who are watching, what do you think, guys? This lady who came to me, of course, I rejected her to do any further diagnosis. I will not do anything like that. Okay, and I know the dog is going to die. Do you think that she will be, even if there is any black magic? Okay, even if there is any black magic, of course, that comes out to be after diagnosis. Do you think this family of hers and she herself can come out of any situation? Now, these are the kind of people who will roam with the fraud tantrics all around. Because universe will have its own law. And make sure that the revenge is taken and the karma is coming in front of you in a very ugly way. This is what you did with, and I know the dog is going to die. Okay, so do not, people who are watching this video, if you have any such thoughts, please remove these thoughts from your mind, because here this is not welcomed at all. And I know this video of mine, how many people say, oh my god, why is she saying so much about the dogs, animals, blah blah blah. Here humans have a better, capacity and a better future, and she should be valuing human beings. No, I don't. I come from an experience with humans. I see what humans are. And I find animals to be much, much more better than humans. Okay? People who want to be with me, be with me. People who do not want to be with me, get lost right away. But this will not change. And even if I find somebody doing something wrong with the animal, I will not spare that person. In my own ways. Okay? So never come and contact my team that Didi said this in the video, that's why I came, my dog is watching this and I'm least bothered about my dog, let the bloody dog die, I don't have money, do my diagnosis, I am from a middle class family, lower middle class family. So these tactics will not be used with me. Okay? So that's about it. I'm not in a very nice mood at all. I was controlling myself for so many days that I will make a decent video on that. I will not show my anger. I will not show my, irritation and frustration after that call. It's been more than 15-20 days that this came to me. And somehow I was trying and, controlling myself that how should I frame this video? It should not look very rude. It should not look very aggressive or assertive. But what to do? I cannot be artificial at all, especially at these causes. I cannot be. What I feel is what I say, especially about these things and overall things also. Even your diagnosis, your case studies, I give out the truth. So I am not one of those healers who will give you sugary sweet spoons to eat, sugary sweet things to eat, bakery products to eat. No, I will not do that. Okay, so that's about it. I'm ending this video here. And I'm going ahead and making this video now in Hindi as well. Take care. Goodbye, Jamakali.